Well, hello everyone, what is going on? It is the almighty Geoff, and I'm here with episode 12 of Red Dead Redemption. In the previous episode, we captured another three of our bounties. We went to Tumbleweed and helped Seth recover his treasure, in the process picking up another rank of treasure hunter. And we won a horse and cart race for Nigel West Dickens. Now, in this episode, I was planning on starting with just doing the bounties as per usual. But I decided to go ahead and try and pick up those five boar for the next Master Hunter challenge. I started up in the hills above Hennigan'stead. I didn't actually, because that's where a boar is. I didn't manage to find any, but I gradually went down along this coast until I came to Stillwater Creek, and I managed to find all five of the boar that I needed within a space of minutes. So just to check, the time is about 12:30 in the afternoon on the Monday, so I just left that last one to be skinned just so you guys could see me ranking up. And there you go. You'll know that the other half of the challenge was the to skin three armadillo, which we did a few episodes back when we were collecting some treasure. So if we just I'm just going to quickly show you the missions that I got gold on. Again, like I said, this one was just a quick rush through. I didn't really bother with headshots, just made sure that I hit as many people as I could, and I did, and then I got through that in 2 minutes and 4 seconds. I mean, it's really easy if you just blast through it. And again, lies, cheats, and other proud Americans, you've just got to skip the cutscenes, skip the journey with West Dickens, and just do relatively well at the race, and I got that pretty easily. So I get that we're a bit far out from anywhere that I really wanted to do this episode. We're going to do bits and bobs. I think the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go to Rathskellar Fork up here, and we're going to purchase our final property. I get it's pretty much on the other side of the island. Yeah. So I'm going to cut out the footage until I get there, so I will see you at Rathskellar Fork. Alright guys, here we are, Rathskellar Fork. I did just quickly fast travel over here. We're going to spend a little bit of our episode over here. First of all, there is a vacant property, and then there is another stranger mission, which is Who Are You to Judge, which unlocked after completing Liars, Cheats, and Other Proud Americans. So we get those two done, and then I'll most likely do the bounties after that, because we've got three more sets of bounties to get through. So we're quite near the end of that, but better to get it done with sooner rather than later. So it's just $100, it's not really much for us at the moment. We'll just may as well sleep until morning so that it's daylight. So yeah, my plan for this episode is, well, we've done technically 2/5 of what we're going to do. I have like a little note on my monitor. It just tells me the stuff that I want to get through. I want to try and stick relatively close to what I did in my original playthrough, and just because I know that I managed to get everything done with that. Sorry, people. So I had Rathskellar Fort purchase to do first, which I was meant to do last episode, but we ran out of time. But the next thing I'm going to do is the Stranger mission, which is Who Are You to Judge? So let's talk to the guy.
Partner, I need your help.
You and every other fool around here.
No, they took her. They took my love. They stole Jeff's heart, and they took her away.
What are you talking about, friend?
They took my love. They took Jeff's love by them gangsters. They hide out of Tumbleweed. Can you help me, partner? Partner, can you help me?
I doubt it. But if I head up that way, I'll see what I can do.
Help a fella out, partner. Have a soul.
Alright, dude. Actually, while we're here, I'll just quickly pick up that bounty letter, just because I don't want to lose it, because we're going to do these immediately after anyway. Perry Rose, Rattlesnake Hollow. Alright, fair enough. Just because we may as well. There's no point having to wait for another bounty letter to pop up when we've got one right there. So we need to head back down again to Tumbleweed. It's just down here. Rattlesnake Hollow. It's just up there, so we'll do that immediately afterwards. But just head down this long road and let's find Jeb's love. Obviously, if you watch my original playthrough, you'll know the kind of weirdness about this strange mission. But yeah, anyway, I should probably show you the next rank of the Master Hunter, which is to kill two cougars with your melee knife. I think, well, obviously the biggest difficulty with that is actually finding the cougar itself. Because you're going to kind of have to use sort of a bait to get those. So killing another animal, for example, like if you kill those boars, then I think if you do it especially north of McFarlane's ranch, if you manage to do that, then cougars, you will find that they'll actually end up spawning in, and then you can kill them immediately afterwards. I did actually manage to encounter one cougar, but it was before I finished the challenge rank, so I just shot him. Okay, right, we're in Tumbleweed. Let's go ahead and check out what is going on.
Yeah, such a sweet sugar. What you doing here, mister?
I've come for you. A mercy mission. Your poor wretch of a man lost his mind. I seen him at Rathskellar Fork.
My man? My man's dead. Lawman shot him about a month ago. Shot him in the back, coming out of a cat house. Gave himself his medals. Just like I gave myself to that poor bastard. Unless you've been to hell, you ain't seen no man of mine.
Then where is she?
Who?
Jeb's girl.
Who's Jeb?
Creepy kind of guy. Short black hair, mustache.
Oh, my, oh, my. This is Lucy. This is Jeb's girl. You dumb fool. Took it off him about a week ago.
Then you better come with me.
Yeah. We better get her back to her man, huh? You gone made my day. What a fine romantic you is. Well, come on then.
All right, follow me.
Yep. Such is life in New Austin.
You should have seen the look on your face, mister. I bet you thought you was being a real hero.
I should never have listened to that crazy fool.
Mercy mission. Ha! So did Jeb offer you some kind of reward for this?
Nah, miss. I was just helping him out.
Well, ain't you the sweetest thing?
I'm just like you. A real sweetheart.
Come! Yeah, people are creepy. But who just...
Mister, didn't Jeb strike you as being kind of funny?
Most people out here strike me as being kind of funny.
But Jeb, he's a special type of funny, I'd say.
I'm inclined to agree with you, miss.
He got you good, mister.
I'm glad you find it so amusing.
Yeah.
Let's go!
Special man.
Miss, are you speaking to that horse?
Well, Jeb sees something in her, doesn't he? You think he's gonna have flowers waiting for her?
There's some things I'd rather not think about.
Mister, I gotta thank you. I'm gonna remember this one for a long time.
Okay. Creepy dude, you've got your horse back.
Mister! Mister, you found her, mister!
Oh, I found her, all right.
Come here, girl. come to daddy. Oh, you're so beautiful. I'm so strong, yet such a lady. I long to hold you. I missed you so much.
You got problems, friend.
Oh, I ain't got no problems. Not now that she's back with me. Oh, I remember a cold night that we spent together. Every night's been cold without you, my sweet thing. Oh.
I thought I was sick in the head.
I told you he was funny, mister. Life out here does that to people.
Oh.
I should know. My daddy kept goats.
Oh god, dude.
Let's go.
I was coping until he said me and Lucy have got some catching up to do. Oh god, dude, you disgust me. Alright, so let's head over to Rattlesnake Hollow. We'll take care of this bounty. So I shall see you when we get there. Getting close, guys. Okie frickin' dokie. Boom. Boom. Alright. Perry. Oh, god damn it. Don't you freaking dare. I will. Death, you keep trying, but you are not going to win this battle, my friend. Whew. Right. Who's screaming? This guy is a wanted criminal. I'm not just going on a massacre. Fidip, you are goodbye for waiting. Not running off for once. Like you always do. Yeah, we've got an issue with you, Fidip. Alright, we're taking back to Armadillo, which is quite a journey. Isn't it? Really, but yeah, I'm just going to cut. We are in about 15 minutes, so I don't really want to risk. Hey, I hear wolves. Get the hell. Ooh, dude. Brutal. Alright, see you in Armadillo. Okie dokie, here we are. Here's Perry. What are you gonna give me for this, son of a bitch?
Found that no good piece of dirt. Thank you.
Not to worry about it, mate. $160. Well, we've made back the money and more from buying that property in Rathskellar Fork. Yeah, so I consider it to be a profitable day. It's going to get even better because we've got another two to do. So I shall see you at the second bounty target. Okay, second bounty target is Rufus Higby at Mercer Station.
This has made my day. It is you, isn't it? You're the one who intervened, saving my friend from great distress and hurt. It'd be an honor to reward you on his behalf, if I may.
Yeah, sure.
I'm a man of small means, but no matter. Take your pick from the supplies I have. What's mine is yours.
Thank you. This will all be put to good use, I assure you.
What did you just give me? I have no idea what this guy just gave me. He gave me a pardon letter? Must have done. Or something. I don't know what he gave me. Okay, don't hold it against me. Right, so we're going to Mercer Station. It's a bit of a ride, but whatever, I shall see you there. Alright, Rufus. Boom. Boom. What? I killed him? Son of a bitch. I only shot his legs. Oh, damn it. Ugh, fine. I'll accept it, I guess. Damn. Stupid Rufus. With your weak ass legs. Thinking you're just gonna be the right bastard to die. You know, it's just... Shouldn't have killed him, should it? Hey, alright, okay. Making me go against my rule of only capturing targets, you son of a bitch. Jeez. Dude, you've been shot in the arse. You okay there, Philip? You clearly did better than that Rufus guy did. Rufus would have died if I shot him in the arse. If he died, I'd shot him in the leg. What a son of a bitch. How dare he? How dare he die? Oh, people, don't stand in the middle of the road. Simple as. I'm sorry, dude, but, like, the guy's dead.
Found that no good piece of dirt. Thank you.
I did. What we got? I still got $120. Oh damn, that means I would have got like 240 if he was alive. Oh well, we've still got plenty of money. Wait, does it save to our stats? Don't like a dose. Alright, mustn't do. Alright, okay. Sorry for wasting all your time with that. I will see you at our third bounty target. Alright, who have we got this time? Julius Grimes at the Hanging Rock. Finally, somewhere that's actually quite close to where I am. Jesus, man. Yes, we all know that Bill Williamson's gang terrorized New Austin. You've been shouting it for like 50 episodes now. And we're not even 50 episodes in. That's how long you've been shouting that thing, dude. Right, we all know where the Hanging Rock is by now, I should think. It's that big rock that's just northeast of Armadillo. Yes, I know. Okay, right. Okay, alright. Okay. Boom. Yeah, we're coming for you, Julius. You betrayed the Saints, Julius. Yeah, man. Hey. Don't you die on me as well, dude. I think he's still living. Yeah, good. Dude, you stupid horse.
I can't say I'd be happy if I were in your shoes, mister. You can untie me or what?
Alright. Come on, Philip. Let's take this rat bastard back to the hideout. Which I mean, prison. Which is not our hideout. Just don't pay attention to what I say. Right, okay. Julius. Oh, damn. The guy's got resistance. Boom. Oh, picking them off, man. Picking them off. I thought that was the guy who was riding the horse who was after me. I thought he fell off. And I thought, that was quite funny. Alright. Julius, you are coming back with me. You are going to the birdhouse. No problem, dude. 240 smackers! Look at that bar! That is pretty freaking beautiful. Alright. There's our three bounties done with this episode. Now we are going to do one more thing, which is to head down to Plainview, and we're going to start up the next mission, which is Can a Swindler Change His Spots? Now it's obviously quite a bit of a journey, so I will see you when we get there. Ooh, I just heard a cougar. Oh, there's the cougar. There he is. You snuck up on me, didn't you, you rat bastard? Was that the only one, or was that another cougar? Well, we're halfway there. Oh god, that scared me. I was wondering where it was and he just snuck up on me. The cheeky son of a bitch. But you know, if anyone else wants to... Any second cougar wants to come down and, you know, have a go, be my guest. You know? Okay, so I'm gonna have to ask you to. Return that wagon to the miss. Philip, stay with me. Freaking supplies. You literally have no supplies in there. You are one crazy woman. I guess then, how far are we off actually? Not too far. But you know, if any other cougars could, you know, show the face, that'd be pretty awesome. Anybody? No? Okay, right. Well, we're at Plainview anyway, so not to worry. You'll see there was actually a blue safehouse icon there, but that's just for renting, so it's not an actual safehouse. You'll end up losing it. But, so let's do the mission. Can a swindler change his spots?
Sir, John Marston. Mr. Marston, don't be so childish. Come on, sir, I implore you. Okay. So I made a few innocent mistakes when last we met. But my plan is still sound. Together we can conquer, if not the world, then certainly Bill Williamson.
But first, you need me to do you a favor?
You read my mind. I can only deduce you've been taking my tonic, sir, as instructed. It can give the most ordinary of intelligences a remarkable insight.
I'll give you insight. I'll show you what your guts look like.
Please, sir, this show of petulance is nothing short of embarrassing. Think for a moment, sir. Think.
I'm thinking about how much of my time you're wasting.
No. Sir. I am about to do something which I greatly discourage in all wise and rational men. A selfless act. For you. But, sir, before I act selflessly, allow me to act selfishly and sell some of my wares.
Fair enough.
Oh, good, sir. Come, and let's go visit some of our fine friends in the other oil business we have here in Plainview. These men need all the help they can get.
Okay, West Dickens, you absolute crazy psychopath. I don't know what is wrong with you.
Friends! Hard-working souls of Plainview! Do you suffer from rheumatism, lumbago, acute chronic sciatic, neurologic, or inflammatory pain? Well, I represent the only company that makes the genuine article which cures headache, neuralgia, toothache, earache, backache.
Well, this man is a fucking charlatan. He just got done swindling us down at Cho Springs with this song and dance.
I say we tar and feather him right now.
I say we shoot the bastard.
I think it's time we take our business elsewhere. I apologize if science is not your forte. Good day, one and all.
Somebody, get that thief! I just love how Philip interrupted the cutscene there.
Don't make me kill you!
You know, Dickens, come on, dude.
Saint HOMOBONUS has not been looking down on me favorably. Who? HOMOBONUS, the patron saint of businessmen.
I'd say he's giving you your just desserts.
No, poppycock. Those inmates were clearly informed of my refund policy.
You can only shit on people for so long before they decide it's their turn to pull down.
A truly metaphor in every sense of the word, my dear boy. You leave the business to me. Do I try to tell you how to rob banks?
Robin Banks felt more honest. You're just about dead.
Oh, he shot off his hat. Right, Dickens, you're gonna need to go a bit faster, dude. I don't care that you've got a load of... Did I just... Ah, come on. You're gonna have to help me out here. Dude, you're gonna have to... No. Dude, fucking speed up those horses. Right. No, what are you shooting at?
What do you want from me?
I'm gonna try and work on headshots. The accuracy isn't really that big an issue in this one. I think I'm doing quite well with that. But headshots, we're gonna need quite a lot, and I'm not getting a ton. Hey, look, it's the train. Oh crap, I missed.
What do yokels like you talk about?
Come on, dude.
What you've been promising them. Just drop the gun! It ain't worth it!
Oh, Dickens, come on. Come on, dude.
For a man of the people, you sure ain't very popular.
I am up against the weight of plebeian ignorance, my boy.
Come on.
Good shot!
Well, thank
you. You need to think about a change of career.
I will never give up on science, John.
You kidding me?
You're gonna
come on, dude.
This in a box. How can these people harbor such... Well, I ain't surprised. That tonic I drank at Ridgewood went through me like a dose of salt.
Come on, people want to die now, please. Oh, great. Thank God, I thought this was going to end up like... I honestly thought it was going to like just stop there.
I'm not sure we're out of the woods yet.
No, I don't think we are either. Who's... Oh. Right.
Wait,
seriously? Put your pedal to the metal. Oh my God, how are these guys? The end of them. Retinks.
We made it, John. There's Quaviseca up ahead.
Dude, you're just such a time waster. Dude, you've been shot through the hand and on the shoulder, and you've lost your hat.
Well, that was a little hairy. Thank you, my dear boy. You saved the day again.
It always impresses me with the speed with which a group of men can turn from passive sheep into murderous wolves.
I'm impressed with how you nearly got us killed back there.
Yes, perhaps we should shelve the tonics business for a period.
Let's say we try our hand at racing again. There's a meet at Rathskellar.
You're trying my patience, Mr. West Dickens.
Well, I'm sorry, dear boy, but I'm only an aging vendor of exotic elixirs, not the bloody U.S. Cavalry. And forgive me if matters take some time to prepare.
Okay. Right. So this is a bit of a tension going on over there. Let's just have a quick look at our stats. We didn't do too bad. I think probably the fastest time is the one that we've only got to go for there. But obviously I'll get that off screen. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. If you did, be sure to like, comment and subscribe. And I shall see you in the next episode. Bye guys.